Ah, ladies and gentlemen, it's me. I don't even know if you guys can see me from here, but because I'm too black, no. But I want to make a shitload of videos right now. I have a life, though. You know, I got school and shit and a social life. I got a girl and all that. And I got to go out tonight. But I want to make time for all these videos. But I'm going to take my time. There is one video, though, that I want to start out with. Because I really need to do this shit. I'm not going to mention any names because I don't want to start any drama. But there's this one person that made this video about Roman Reigns. You know. Sure, no surprise there. Typical crybaby upset that Bryan didn't win the Rumble, but saying that they would have taken anybody else. And I'm going to tell you this. This person got mad. I don't even know why. Just like everybody else, they got mad last year when Batista won, which I was behind. I'm behind Roman Reigns as well. 2013, Ryback, who was hot for like that whole time, that whole season, eliminated by Cena. Cena, the one guy that everyone says needs to be replaced by a new face. You're getting a new face this year and you're not happy. But Cena eliminates Ryback, wins his second Royal Rumble in a pointless, predictable match for The Rock that Mania. Nobody complained. I saw some people upset, but there was no riots. There was no blocking cars or canceling viewing. People came back. And all these assholes who canceled the network were either full of shit or lied because they got 1 million, okay? 1 million. So either y'all didn't really have it, or you guys didn't cancel. You just try to hit the WWE where it hurts. Because you know that you can. But, yeah, this person's, like, going around saying two arguments they said that really bothered me. He said that, what the hell does this asshole say? That Roman Reigns was, like, not talented or something. And that Bryan, it's okay for Bryan to main event a second WrestleMania in a row because Cena's been in the main event for WrestleMania for years. Hogan's main evented WrestleMania back to back. Okay, there's two issues with that. Okay, number one, you and everybody else has made videos. That's bullshit too. Cena main eventing all those is bullshit as well. I agree. It's tripe, it's shit. He has no business main eventing all the Manias. I don't care if he draws because he gets sell from the mid card. Don't you remember making Vince complaining about that? I do. So yeah, Cena main eventing back to back is bullshit. Bryan main eventing back to back is bullshit. Nobody should ever do that. I'm against Sting doing it at Bound for Glory too. And then you mentioned Hogan. Okay, there's the second issue. Hogan and Cena at the time were the faces of the companies. Like, they're up here. Okay, Daniel Bryan is here, okay? Whether you like it or not, he's getting the Sheamus treatment, the Jack Swagger treatment. One of those guys that's a former Ziggler, former world champion that just stays in the mid-card. It's just the way it is. It used to not be like that, but it is now. You know what I'm saying? How much time is that? That's the way it is, brother. And then the second thing they said was, but yeah, those things are draws. Like, those guys are draws. Hogan's, you know. They were the top dogs. They had to fight every heel. They main evented Mania year after year. They were the face of the company. They drew. Okay, Bryan doesn't draw. The network is a million subscribers now. After this controversy with Roman Reigns, did this happen when Bryan won the title? No, it did not. And it was only $9.99, John. The second thing this dummy said was that. We're saying that Bryan's too small and that he doesn't have the look. And that we're supposed to like talent. Okay, number one, this person is not a big TNA fan. And all of those guys do. Bryan can't do anything that the American Wolves can't do, okay? Like, they're all X Division stars. Like, they all fly. They all have talent. They're all better on the mic than Bryan. Why aren't you praising TNA? And the second thing is, this is WWE, okay? It's never been about talent. It's about on being having mic skills helps. But I guess with Roman, it's still a process because they handpicked him. I personally think he was rushed as well, and that it should have been Ryback that got like this handpicked selection. But Roman is the chosen one. You know what I mean? Cena was the chosen one. He's never had the best technical moveset, and he's never been that good on the mic. I don't like him on the mic at all. So yeah, he's not really that different. Hogan is an icon at a time when wrestling was like boom, you know, number one. Hogan was the face of that era, and because of that, he's still a household mainstream name. And his promos were intense, but his ring work was never that sound. Like, he didn't do that technical wrestling shit. You know, nobody did that crap back in the day. You know, Bryan's a great wrestler, but his personality doesn't do it for me, and it doesn't do it for a lot of other people. You know, the man, his voice is annoying, you know? Like, he doesn't put asses in seats, man. I don't care what you guys do. It's like Dom Amazing said, none of the people at the show had his shirt. None of them. I didn't see nobody. And that show was 3 hours long, brother. You know what I'm talking about? Like, I don't understand this. I mean, yes, the man's talented, but to the WWE, that shit doesn't matter. You know what I mean? If that was the case, the fucking Adrian Neville and Sami Zayn will be main eventing Mania right now. Kevin Steen or Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn will be facing each other at Mania instead of a NXT special next month. Talent is a wonderful thing, and I like talented matches, wrestlers, and matches or whatever. But that doesn't matter to WWE. Nobody that they've ever pushed, apart from Daniel Bryan and CM Punk or whatever, have been technically sound, have had crisp work rate. That doesn't matter to them. Okay, look at all their Divas champions back in the day. Okay, you had Candice Michelle as champion, Eve Torres. Come on now. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me if Eva Marie or Summer Rae win the title, maybe even Rosa Mendez, which I'm going to make a video about sometime later on, at Eva Marie. But yeah, I just needed to respond to that because what this person said is what a lot of people are thinking, but they don't even think twice about. Also, maybe Bryan was still hurt, and that's why he was thrown out on the Rumble early. And this topic is actually kind of stale. Like, even in 2 days, it got stale. I don't even know why I'm making this video because I couldn't do it yesterday. But, yeah, like, Roman Reigns is the hand-chosen one. He's the future. I personally feel that it was kind of, like, rushed because I saw it coming. Like, I knew from June, which is when we all found out that he was going to fight Lesnar, and it's happening, you know? When we found out in June, it feels like 2 weeks ago. That's how quick the year went. But Roman's the man. He's the chosen one. This is like Batista in 2005. It's the same thing. He's awesome. You can learn to like him, you know, but... And oh, yeah, and this person even said that if Roman won the Rumble, he was going to stop watching when he comes back, you know? I mean, I'm not going to lie. I stopped watching when Batista left, okay? I was on the SmartBusters thread, and that's how I found out what was going on. But I stopped watching. The whole thing was tripe. It was Kane, Big Show, Rollins, Cena in the main event. And then 6-man matches, 8-man matches, 10-team matches, 1-on-1 matches. And no finishes every fucking week. I got fucking tired of it. The Survivor Series storyline got me intrigued. I started watching after that. And then they brought them back. I stopped watching. Bryan lost and Roman won. Makes me happy. So I'm watching now. You know? I watched Raw, the Snow special. The Snow special, John. And, you know, yeah, man. And I'm happy. I'm going to get the network, man. I'm gonna be 1,000,001 or whatever. Because I'm happy. You know, they deliver, so I'm back into it. You know what I mean? And that's good because I haven't felt this excited about wrestling since when Batista won the Rumble. So that's good. Yeah, Bryan doesn't, you know, to WWE, it doesn't matter, you know. He's just like Cesaro and all the other misused guys. Justin Gabriel. He doesn't put asses in seats. He doesn't sell tickets. They did not want to push him last year, but they did so because of you guys. And it was a failure. And now they're doing this thing where they ripped off TNA, and they're doing backstage WrestleMania. That Mania it wasn't a wonderful show. Like, it wasn't spectacular. It was a great show. It wasn't like 10 stars like everyone's saying it is. But it means nothing now because Batista's gone. Bryan lost the title and he's not even champion anymore. Bray Wyatt got buried. AJ, fuck her. That show means nothing, and Ultimate Warrior is dead, you know? God rest his soul. That Mania doesn't mean anything anymore. It hasn't for a while. It's done. So I don't know why they're bringing it back up again, but it's about the future. It's about WrestleMania 31, damn it. But yeah, man, let me see how much time I have. I don't understand why people are so upset, okay? Ryan is done. No more main events for that guy. You know what I'm saying? See, another reason that Mania doesn't mean anything is because Brock Lesnar is supposedly a good guy, bad guy, whatever the fuck he is. And Taker's gone, so it means nothing. So yeah, I lost my voice. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. No crazy stuff today, but Roman's the future. Learn to love it. And if you don't, you can either do one of two things. Cheer for Lesnar, even though he's probably not going to win. And stop watching. Watch something else. That's the bottom line. We're actually happy for once, and you guys are upset, and that's you guys' problem, not mine. So until next time, this video wasn't like the best, but I just needed to do this, get it out of the way so I can do my real shit that I'm planning up. It's going to be a nice little sweet treat. I want one of them sweet treats for you guys. And remember, in this world, I do what I want to, I say what I want to, and I act how I want to. Roman Reigns is the future. Believe that.